Okay, then good morning, everybody, and thank you for coming to this presentation about Flutter. I will explain what Flutter is now. First of all, I want to ask you one question. How many of you have already heard about Flutter before coming to this presentation? Okay. And how many of you have already played or followed a tutorial or a code lab or? Not bad. Okay. So there are still a lot of people who doesn't know anything about Flutter or who just know the name. Okay. Okay. Good. As you can see in the title, this is a presentation about Flutter. That is a cross-platform SDK for building applications for iOS for iOS and Android. Okay. So. We are going to talk today about cross-platform development. I will talk about some of the actual or present-day frameworks, but mostly I will compare those frameworks with Flutter. The next slide, just want to show you this. This week, I made a Flutter app for this conference. It's an agenda, so you can download it. It's not official, and it's not all the information is in the app, because I didn't scrape the app or the web. I just copied most of the titles and some of the information, but so you can use the app as an agenda. So you have the all the tracks in the agenda, as you can see here. And then you assign those talks to your track. So there's a specific track for your, just to show you that this is something that works. And I have spent for doing it like 4 days, 4 days in the evenings. Okay, so it's not. I didn't have the time to put all the information because, I wanted to code, not to copy the information. So you will find mostly just the titles for the second day, because I have published this night, tonight, and I didn't want to put all the information from yesterday, so you couldn't use it, so you can use it for today, okay? If I have time, I can show it later in the IDE, but if not, you can play with it during the day. Okay, so cross-platform development. This is to the left. You find what we have with traditional with the incumbent platforms, iOS and Android. Okay, you with developing with Android and iOS, you get a castle, a high mansion, because you get all the benefits of the platform, okay, the iOS and Android platform. But you have also a lot of obstacles, inconveniences, mostly that you have to double teams, double resources, double cost. This is what this this maze really means. The resources you have to put to develop your applications. So at the other side, you have there are some examples here, but there are others like Xamarin and React Native that promise this, okay? Promise this lane, in theory, because in fact you use just half of people, half the resources. This is what we mean with this single path, okay? There are of course it's not like that always, but what they promise is that you will spend less resources doing your application. But at the end, what you get is this hut, this small house, or something in between this castle and the house. Okay, it's not. You don't get that with the cross-platform applications, because even if you get beautiful applications, you don't get the performance, because you have the bridge, the JavaScript bridge. Okay, for instance, in React Native. So, wouldn't it be good if we had a platform, an SDK? What we have both, we have this, the castle, and we have a single path, less resources invested in developing it. So, well, this talk is about Flutter. This Flutter promises this, but then you can think this. You can think another cross-platform SDK, another cross-platform framework. So what does it really bring us? Is there anything new with Flutter? Okay, this is the purpose of, well, I'm going to locate it in the today frameworks. You see, Flutter is the only SDK that is reactive and native. Okay, why reactive? Because this is seems to be the trend. In fact, Flutter was inspired by React Native for the architecture, for the reactive architecture. Okay, and this is where you position Flutter. It's a reactive SDK, but it compiles to native. So we can say that it's the only reactive and native SDK. Okay, then what is Flutter? So this is the definition in the homepage. Well, today, now it's not just exactly this because they have changed a little the homepage, but this was the previous definition in the homepage before they changed the look and feel of the homepage. In fact, reality is to build applications. This is what we are going to see today. To build applications, native, high quality, beautiful, and then in record time. This is what we are going to see three advantages of Flutter. One is that you build native applications. The other one is that you build highly performance and beautiful, but performance applications, and then in record time. This is the 3 points that we are going to see. So, native applications. First, we have to see what native really means. If we think in iOS and Android, native means that it's the same, the platform, the SDK, the native provided by the manufacturer, Android or Google or Apple, okay? This is native. If we think in cross-platform SDKs, we think of native as if they compile to something that is supported by the platform. So if we use React Native or Xamarin, we compile something that, for instance, if React Native or Xamarin wants to display a dialog, a button, a menu, they delegate to the platform to display this button, this menu. So it's the platform who really paints in the window, in the screen, those widgets. This is the meaning of native in those platforms. Okay, they delegate to the native platform. But there's also another meaning of native. It's the meaning that is used in Flutter. Flutter compiles to native means that Flutter compiles, it produces a file that is executed directly by the ARM, by the processor. So it's not executed by the platform itself, by the iOS or Android itself. It's executed by the processor. So this executable that you produce renders directly in the canvas. So Flutter doesn't use the platform, the native platform rendering. So think of React Native delegates to the platform. Okay. In the case of Flutter, is Flutter who renders in the canvas everything. So this has one inconvenient, one disadvantage, is that you have to replicate if you want to produce the, for instance, in Android, you want to have the material design. In Flutter, you need to replicate all the widgets. There's one guy, the one engineer there, who just looks at this widget is exactly the same as the other one in the native. That's not done in React Native, Okay, this has to be done in Flutter. If you want to replicate the look and feel of the iOS in Flutter, there's one guy who is just measuring and testing the widgets, so it looks like they're homemade widgets. Okay, this is the disadvantage, the theoretical disadvantage. But then you gain a lot of things because you have full control of what you do. And you, for instance, you do a ahead of time compilation. This means that the file is compiled like an executable or is executed directly by the processor. This is the ahead of time compiler, in opposition to JIT, okay, just in time, that is compiled while executing. In this case, the executable is produced ahead of time. And there's a lot of, performance gain in this because this is executed directly by the processor. There is no virtual machine. Someone says that Flutter applications run even faster than Android applications because there's no virtual machine. So Flutter application, of course, there is a. All applications need to be managed. There is a garbage collector. This needs to be managed. Okay, there is a little runtime, but there is not a full virtual machine that executes the code. The code is executed by the ARM. Okay, this is the advantage. The advantage also is that you don't need to have a JavaScript bridge between. In React Native, you have a bridge. That is, you lose all the performance you gain with the speed of coding, okay? Because this bridge has to you write in JavaScript, but this has to be converted to the platform. Okay, we could spend more time in this, but we don't have many times, so I'll go over this. Since this is executed by the processor directly, the performance is very high. Here we say that it's 60 frames per second, but depending on what you do on the screen, you can get 120 frames per second. And you will see that the animations are very smooth because there's no bridge. It's executed directly by the processor also. So this is the native part of Flutter, the speed. And then, so if you have to render everything in the canvas, all applications that you build with Flutter include the runtime and the renderer. What do you think about this? It's like game engines, right? Because game engines include the engine that renders all the worlds, the people that you, the game, all the game is rendered by the engine. In this case, it's the same. Okay, you can think Flutter is a game, but instead of rendering worlds or landscape, it renders applications, windows. It's the same concept. Well, this is just to show you that in the case of Flutter, the application renders directly in the canvas, in the memory, while in React Native, for instance, there is your application, but since this is a language and this is another one, the platform doesn't understand directly the language that you use to code, you need a bridge in here. And this is where you lose performance. Okay, let me see the time. This is also important in Flutter because Flutter is developed using Dart. Dart is a language developed or produced by Google like 6 or 7 years ago. The intention was to replace or to use instead of JavaScript, thinking that JavaScript would die or could be improved, and they created Dart. But Dart was not used much except inside Google. But they took it for this framework. And the advantage now with that is that it can compile to AOT ahead of time, so to the processor, and it also can compile for debugging purposes and for developing in JIT, in just in time. And what you get with Dart is that the whole framework, the whole stack of layers, is built with Dart. And you can, you, in the higher layer, you have the widgets with, that let you code, develop relatively quickly. But then you have access to all the layers below. In this case, you see the foundation, the animation, the painting. We will see later in a little demo that we are using widgets, but we are accessing also all the layers directly to the lower layer, to the where we paint directly in the canvas. And below is the engine. This is the engine in C++. Okay, so we have seen speed. Okay, speed of execution, let's say. Then there's the other part of Flutter, that is the high quality apps. That this is thank you also. This is due to the fact that we can access all the layers, layers of the what we can see here. And well, this is some examples. It's very easy. Some of these transitions with Flutter are very easy. If someone has downloaded the application, I have just added a column there that I just animate the column to be the personal agenda. And this is relatively difficult, for instance, in Android. I have worked in Android, not in iOS, okay? But in Flutter, it's very easy because you just animate the width of the column and you get the column. So there are things in Flutter that they are very easy. They would be very difficult in some of them in with activities and fragments in Android. So well, we see again here in you will see in the demo that in Flutter everything is a widget. We say everything is a widget from the top to the bottom. Okay, and well, this is not exactly right. The widgets are in the upper layer, but you manage in the whole applications is through widgets. All the configuration that you provide is through widgets, okay? And for this, you see here gestures. I'll show you. We will add a widget that it's a gesture detector, okay? It's just a widget. Or, well, we could look at them. Let's see. Okay, so we get the beautiful applications in Flutter and the high quality applications due to the widgets. And you will see that in Flutter, we use a lot of composition. So at the end, you end with a tree of long trees of widgets. For instance, center normally is a property of a box, of a div, right? In the case of Flutter, center is a widget. So you put your text or your image in a widget that is a center. If you want to add padding, instead of setting a property that is padding, you can envelop this in another widget that is padding. So this brings the advantage that when the platform sees the tree, he sees the center widget. It just knows, the platform knows that it's a center. Doesn't have to look at all the properties of the container of the div. This is the advantage of Flutter. Okay, even if you get a lot of widgets in the tree, you know when you travel the tree that there's only one thing that you have to look in that node, in that element. You don't have to look all the properties of that node, even if they are longer trees. Well, and this is also important. We build the applications in real time, and this is for development. Okay, so we have seen speed. Then we have seen beautiful applications thanks to the ability to manage all the widgets, and then we have in development, What we need is a speed of development. And this is also what Flutter provides. And the most important thing here is the hot reload. This is the thing that people most like about Flutter. Because when you develop, you run the application, and you make changes, and these changes are immediate. So you don't have to reload the application. And this is hot because it keeps the state. We will see that later in the demo, that I'm in the middle of an application. The application is executed. I can make changes. And the changes are loaded and reloaded, hot reloaded, at the same time, OK? This is the changes that you do. This is where the JIT compiler is used. Remember that I told you that there's the AOT compiler that is used for production apps, for release. But for development, the JIT compiler is used. So the JIT compiler is because the Dart machine, virtual machine, has access to the code. And it just takes the code that has changed and replaces the code that is running. This is what we mean, but changes are injected in the Dart VM. This is used also for fast prototyping. So you don't, in Flutter, there's no an XML language to do design, UI design. Okay? You do the design directly in code. But once you get used to this, this is very quick, because you change something, you just save the file, and this is automatically applied. And this is used for fast prototyping. There was a presentation in last Google I/O, or I don't know if it's Google I/O, or in the Dart conference. I saw the video. And there was a design guide by the code guy. And they were just designing the application. And the developer was, at the beginning, was training the design guide. But once the design guide knows how more or less to change things, it's very easy to change at least the UI. Okay? Of course, the logic of the application is another thing. This has to be done by the developer. But the changes in design in the UI are very easy, and they are automatically applied when you change. There's no need to have a specific application for designing. And another thing great about Flutter is the documentation. I think we can see this in the demo, because all the documentation is in Java. Java, you have the Java doc. Here we have the Dart doc. Okay, and all the documentation is there, and you can, from the IDE, you can go to the documentation just from one class to the other, and you see that is very very easy. And this is just a slide to show you some of the benefits or some of the features of Dart that are used especially for Flutter. Well, Dart, at the beginning, it was a loosely typed language, so you could use types or not. But then now there's the version 2 of Dart, and this the types are mandatory. And this is good for development, the sound type system, because they help you with the IDE, with the refactoring, etc. Another important thing about Flutter is, mostly about Dart, is the tree shaking. When you can include all the libraries you want in the code, you can import like 100 meg of libraries in your application, but the compiler does tree shaking. So it gets rid of everything that is not used. Okay, so you can, even if there is a library where you just one feature, you only that feature is imported in the project. The rest is removed. Okay, then the difference between ahead of time compiler and just in time compiler. The first one is used for release to produce a responsive, performant application, because it's like the applications we have in the applications that are not managed by a virtual machine in our PC, in our laptop. And then the just-in-time compiler that is used in development, just in development. Okay. Well, the libraries, and then it's also important the multi-generational, the multi-generational garbage collector. Dart has different generations of objects, and then in Dart you have these big trees of widgets, and in every frame, this tree of widgets, depending of what of the part of the application, but this tree of widgets may be rebuilt. So you create constantly a lot of widgets that are the widgets are the configuration of the inner tree. It's a little more than this, but widgets are created and forgotten constantly. So the generational garbage collector, with what does is, I put in one level the objects that will be removed quickly. So the garbage collector doesn't need to go to the other layer of the memory to access those objects. Okay? And this makes that objects that have a short life are removed very quickly. Okay, and this is well, I have presented very quickly the SDK. I haven't told you that the SDK now is in beta. It has been developed by Google. It began development 5 years ago or so. 2 years ago, they went public, more or less, and they have had several beta, several alpha, beta. Now it's in beta, and we think that the 4th of December, the version 1 will be announced. That's what we think, because they haven't told anything. Okay? There's this Flutter Live event in London. Well, they say that it's a party, and what we assume is that they will announce release 1. Okay? Because there are a couple of features still missing in Flutter that make for some applications you may think that it's not still usable, mainly the use of maps, the Google Maps in this case, or web views. That's not a web view. So they are working in integrating a native view inside Flutter. And this is still a little green. Okay, but we think that they will announce in December the release 1. So there is a party in Madrid also to follow this the Flutter Live, and well, that's in the same day there will be a Flutter meetup in Madrid. Okay, this is the presentation. And now I'm going to do a little demo, so you see what I have told you about Flutter in practice, okay? Let's see if everything works. Can you see it? Okay, this is IntelliJ, and this is the sample application that it's built by when you do a Flutter create app. It generates the simplest applications, and it's a running application. And I will show you what it does. So you see here, this is Dart. If you have worked with Java or JavaScript, it's very similar. The syntax is very similar. You have a main method, and then in the main method, this is a Flutter function. And here we begin with the widgets. My app is a widget, so you run the first widget. See here, my app is defined. You see this my app is a stateless widget. I haven't told you about this, but we have a stateless widget and stateful widgets. A stateless widget doesn't have any state, doesn't store anything. And the stateful widgets is when you want to store, you will see here that we store a counter, and we have then stateful widgets. This is the visible part, because this is the widget node, the widget tree. Then there is a, like the DOM, right? There is a element tree. Element tree, that is, in reality, the application is this element tree. It's a tree of elements. And the widgets is just the configuration of these elements. So the widgets are revealed continuously. And what really is keeps the store of the state of the application is the tree of elements that is more stable. Okay, so what we see here is the widgets. You see one stateless widget here, my app, and then we have the build method. The build method, we are in a reactive SDK, reactive application, and then when you say to one widget or to one text, show this this number or this text, the SDK does not show immediately the text. You must mark the interface as dirty, and then in the next frame, the SDK will go through this variable. We will see that it has changed, and then it will show the name or the number. I will show you now. So we have here, we build this widget, my app, is built with another widget, material app. This is a widget provided. This one is ours. We have created this widget. This other one, material app, is already provided by Flutter. It has a lot of widgets inside, already created for us. And then I use for the home property. This is a constructor, okay? This, you will see this. Maybe it's more familiar with you to you if I say this. This is the same, okay? It's just, I just build, and I will remove this. This is the same. I just build this material app widget, and as a parameter, I pass another widget. It's the home page. So I create this another home page. You see, this home page is stateful, and it has a state associated. See, this is a state, is this one. So stateful is just a class, stateless is just a class, and the stateful widgets has the widget and associated state. And in this case, I have the build method to build this widget. In this, I have a scaffold. You see, this is a widget, a scaffold. A scaffold has several parameters that are at the same time widgets. It has an app bar. There is an app bar widget. In the body, I have a center. Inside the center, I have a column. Inside this column, I have several texts. Okay. I'm going to execute this. Let's see if I'm able to do it. Cannot run. No such file or directory. It's an error. Let me close them. To start again the emulator. Okay. Let's see if now it works. Okay, here we have our applications. Very, very simple application, right? We have in this application, we have the scaffold. The scaffold is the structure of the page. And then in the scaffold, we have a navbar, a body, and then we have a fab, a floating action button. That is here, you see? This is the app bar, this is the body, and this is the fab. And inside the body, we have a column. You see this column with three things. This text, then the counter, and then the other text. And when I click here, well, this just works. And then if I want to change anything, let me do it. OK, I'm going to change, for instance, the app bar. Hello, commit. It changes text. And I just click save. And then, you see, it's already there. Or if I want to change the color of the icon, of this button, or I just want to change let's just say remove the icon, save, and it's there. And if I just click here, I say counter, instead of adding, it just subtracts. I just click save, and then I click, and this subtracts. It keeps the state of the application, just storing, just saving the file. OK? I could even, instead of this floating action button, I could say, put this in a column. See, put this in a column, and I can use, instead of one widget, I could use two widgets. One with plus, and this is, I create decremento. Suena un poco mal, pero. And I create the same thing here. So I change the code live, OK? And I just do now save. OK, it's a column. I have to say it's minimum. The column has a main access size, is main access size minimum. OK, you see both? And I click one and the other. It keeps the state. I can change the code live. And everything, the state remains. I don't have to go from the beginning of the application. If I want to do more things now, for instance, I take this scaffold. This scaffold is the whole page. Okay, the whole page, and you can say the whole application. I'm going to wrap this in a new widget. So a scaffold is inside this widget. I'm going to call it transform. And I'm creating entity I know the numbers and the names, so believe me. I'll tell you now what I'm doing. I have here already available, it's called offset, to know how much I should rotate. Okay, and then I will. Okay, yeah, I can do it. I can already save it. You see, it takes, and this continues to work. You see the names. So I just have changed the widget, and I can change the And this can be alignment, fractional offset. This is just to move it to the center. This, okay? And I'm going to do still another thing. I take this widget, this transform widget, and I wrap it with another widget that is a gesture detector. And this gesture detector provides several callbacks on pan update. This gives me the details of the I'm going to move it, okay? Set state, I have to do set state. Set state is when I tell the SDK that the UI is dirty, that it has to redraw it. Okay? If I don't tell, I'm going to do it. Don't do it just like this. Details, this will be offset 2. We are going to use the offset 2 now because it will be centered. Offset 2 is just offset with instead of 0.4, it's 0.00, okay? And then what I do here is offset 2 is this, then I take the details, and delta. So I update the offset. With my details of my finger, I update the offset. And I have to do one more thing. Since the update is very, my finger moves a lot, I have to reduce the movement of my finger just a little. Otherwise it goes too quick. Okay. Let's see what's now there. You see the application is still there. Okay, running. I do saving, and it's still running. But since the offset now is zero, it has been brought to zero. But I go here and I do this. No, it doesn't work. Ah, okay. Doesn't do anything because I have to update the offset. If the framework for the framework, the offset is not updated until I tell him that it's dirty. Okay. Okay. Now I'm telling that the UI is dirty. It's just a call to a function that does that, and then I save. And you see. Yep, you see now. I'm here and I'm changing the state of my application just by wrapping the widget in another widget. That is, I could try to click the button, but it's not easy because there's an elevation. There are 5 buttons and there's an elevation. It's not easy. It has work. You see that it continues to, you see the six, it continues to work, the application. Okay? So, well, I think we are on time now. I think we have already seen more or less what Flutter is. I think it changes the way mobile development is done. It provides quick applications, fast applications, and then the development is very quick. I told you this application, this agenda is very easy, of course, it has not a lot of things, but it has been just four evenings in doing it. Okay? Okay, thank you for coming. And everything is open source here. This was started by Google, but everything is open source. So you can in the mornings, I work in other things completely. I work with Java, okay? But this is what I do in my free time. So this is still beta, but it can already be used in production.